So, as you can see, I've learned how to fight like Bond, and I think it's now time to drink like 007. So I'm here at one of the most popular watering holes in the whole of Cardiff, the Botanist, to have the perfect vodka martini.
The second part of our James Bond series, No Time to Try, sees Sam try 007's drink of choice, the vodka martini, shaken, not stirred.
With a martini, it's one of those drinks where you can have it however you want. So of course in the movie, that's the ratio that he'd prefer. Whereas here at the Botanist, the way we do it is four parts of Tanqueray to one part of Lillet Blanc, which is very similar to Kino Lillet. But as I said, you can have it however you want.
The martini itself is known as this sophisticated drink. Do you think James Bond has a lot to do with that?
I definitely think with the kind of suave, debonair side that he shows in the movies, a lot of people associate it with that because of that. And since the movies have made the martini iconic, you can see just in every bar, a lot of people are ordering a drink just to seem sophisticated. And when you have a drink for the first time, you can see that they're not that sophisticated because it definitely comes out. It's a very boozy drink. All the ingredients in it are alcoholic. There's no mixer, no lengthener. It is one of those drinks where you sip it, and if it's your style of drink, you'll probably finish it in three sips. Ideally, what you want to do with a martini, because the moment you serve it, it starts to deteriorate, so you want to make sure that you savour it for as long as needed before it kind of gets a bit too warm. From working in bars for the last few years, you can see that a lot more people are more interested in what's their drink, and they have a bit more of a sophisticated palate where they can enjoy more bitter, weirder, niche flavours. So stuff like the martini, old-fashioned, Negroni, becoming more and more popular. And most of the time, if you're having just a traditional martini, it'll be two ingredients, your dry vermouth and your dry gin. And that's all it takes. You can have it shaken or stirred. A lot of time people order shaken because that's what James Bond says. Ideally you want it stirred because you can control how much you dilute it and still get it really cold. The idea of shaking is just to kind of get it as cold as possible, and a lot more people prefer it that way because taking the heat out of it makes it a lot more palatable and easier to drink.
So it's a temperature thing. That's what shaken not stirred means.
I'd definitely say so. That and dilution, because if you shake it, you're getting maximum dilution, but you're getting the coldest temperature possible. If you just stir it down, you can taste it as you go along, and then you're like, okay, cool, this is the dilution I want, and it'll still be cold. You can enjoy it, but that's probably more for your refined drinkers.
Good evening, sir. What can I get for you?
Vodka martini, shaken, not stirred. Well, Michael, let's see what you got. Let's make the perfect vodka martini, shaken, not stirred. Let's do it.
Fantastic. Let's get behind the bar.
Now, we're here behind the bar at the Botanist, and we are about to make a vodka martini, aren't we, Michael?
Yes, indeed, yeah.
Shaken, not stirred, I do
shaken,
believe.
Shaken, yes, yes.
So, let's go.
Fantastic.
What do
brilliant.
We do?
So, we start off with our chilled coupe just here. You can have it in a martini, whatever you like, as long as it's a stem glass. And we're going to shake it. So we get our Boston shaker. Mm-hmm. The first thing we're going to do is start pouring our ingredients. So for free pouring reference, mm-hmm. it would be 3 seconds of pouring your Lillet Blanc.
Okay, yep. So you time it.
Yeah, so that's how you free pour.
That's how you measure it. Okay, cool. Yep. So 3 seconds, yeah?
And then 9 count of Prego, so you do it for 9 seconds.
Okay, cool. So it's 3 of this. Yep. Ready?
So you want to try and get the bottle as vertical as possible.
2, 3.
Yes, yes.
Cool.
There we go.
And then 9 of this, yeah?
9 of that, yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
There you go. Jesus. So now what we need is to fill up our shaker with cubed ice. There you go. So that should be out separate now. You're going to get your hawthorn strainer.
Right.
Over the tip.
Okay.
Get all that gorgeous liquid out. And grab yourself a little lemon zest.
Yeah.
And you're just going to squeeze it over the top so you get the lemon oil just kind of around your drink.
About that, yeah?
And then you just want to throw that in and that'll complement your drink. There's your vodka martini.
Shaken, not stirred.